Hi everyone, I'm Joey from Hands Up Galleria, and today we are here on Facebook Live to show you how to do the terrarium using plastic bottles. Okay, so now if you have plastic bottle at home, sometimes we don't know what to do, we throw it away. But don't throw it away because we can do something with it. Okay, so these plastic bottles, we are going to use it as like a pot for the terrarium. So what we're going to do first is you have to cut using the pen knife. Okay, so children, if you need help, please ask your daddy and mommy for help. So we have to use the pen knife to cut, okay, the plastic bottles. Okay. Be careful with your hand. So after you cut the plastic bottles, if you need to trim, you can use the scissors to cut. Okay. So you just trim it. Okay. Trimming it, this area will be a little bit rough and a little bit pricky. So what you can do is to use the sandpaper to find it, okay? File it. So file the edges so it will be smooth. Using the sandpaper, it will be very smooth. Okay. Okay. If you need to trim, you can trim it a little bit. What we can do is we're going to decorate the plastic bottles. Okay, we are going to paint the plastic bottles. So you can choose any color that you like. For me, I'm going to choose pink. So you can squeeze the color out. Okay. So now we are going to paint and decorate the bottle after we cut it up. So now I'm going to squeeze out some paint. Okay. So for those who just came in, what did I do just now is we are going to make a terrarium using the plastic bottles. Okay. So we cut it. After we cut it already, you have to use the sandpaper to file it so it becomes smooth. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint the plastic bottles. So now I am going to take some paint. Okay. Okay. So after we're done, we're going to paint it. Okay, so we're going to use the paintbrush. We can decorate the plastic bottle and we paint. It's up to you how you want to paint your plastic bottle. I'm going to show you how. So for me, I want my plant to be seen. So I paint the top and the bottom. Okay, so you can decorate, you paint any color that you like. Okay, so we paint the plastic bottles. You can paint about 2 coats or 3 coats depending on the color you choose. Okay, So after that, I let it dry before I paint another coat. And then now I paint the bottom. Okay. If you have any questions, you can ask us below the comment and we will reply you. Okay, so now I paint the bottom. Okay, so after painting, we let it dry and you decide how many coats or how many layers you want to paint. So if this is too light, you have to wait for it to dry first before you paint another layer. Okay, so after you let it dry, we can decorate it with different types of decorative items like the bonbon balls, or you have confetti at home, you can use it. So for the bonbon balls, right, or some of the things that are harder to paste, what you can do is you can use the Yoo Hoo glue to stick, or we have the glue gun, if you have the glue gun, to stick too. Okay, yes. And for those who just came in, yeah, we just done decorating the bottles by using the plastic bottles. So we actually cut the bottle and then we use the sandpaper to file it. After that, we paint and decorate and let it dry. So after it dry ready, you can decorate your bottles using the pom-pom balls or the confetti. And then for the pom-pom ball, we use either super glue or the hot glue gun. Okay? Or if you have glue dots, or you can get it from Popular, you can get glue dots too to paste it. Okay? All around, or anywhere you like to decorate your terrarium pot. Okay, so now we are done decorating and let's start making our terrarium. So I'm gonna put this aside. Okay, so before I start doing our terrarium, just now I was explaining that today we're gonna use recycled bottles, but if you have glass cup or any nice glass at home, you can actually use this to make a very nice terrarium too, open terrarium. And you can use different plants like succulent. This is succulent. This is succulent. Okay. And we have also different plants like Phytonia. Okay. And today we are going to use these plants, okay? This is Phytonia. Okay, so are we all ready to start? Okay, so now we are going to do open terrarium. There are also another terrarium, it's called a closed terrarium. So, but today I'm going to show you the open terrarium. But the steps are quite similar. It's just that for closed terrarium, you have to use like a bottle or glass to make it closed. But for open terrarium, you just leave it open, but the steps are actually the same for the terrarium making. Okay, so are we ready? Okay, so the first step, we are going to use stones. Okay, there are different kinds of stones. There are color stones or the normal color stones. You can actually use that. And the first step is to put the stones. Why do we have to put the stones first? Because the stone act as a drainage system for the plant. So we have to put the stones first as the first step. So, okay, so I'm going to put the stones into the plastic bottle. Okay. And put it. Okay. So it acts like a drainage system for the plant. So I'm going to put the stone. Can estimate it about, let's say, about one finger, okay, the height. So after the stones, can you guess what are we going to do? We're going to put the soil, okay? So this is the soy. Actually, you can buy it from Giant too. It's called the garden soy or any nursery to buy the soy. It's called garden soy. Normally, we use the garden soy. Okay, so we scoop it into the plastic bottles. Okay, scoop into the plastic bottles. Okay, so you can get from Giant or any nursery for the garden soy. Okay. So let's estimate. Okay, so just now for the stones, we put it at the bottom because it acts as a drainage system. The stones at the bottom, then we have the soy. So the soy, let's estimate about 3 fingers. Okay, so after you estimate, so now we are going to dig a hole in the center. Okay, so you can use your hand or you can use the spoon. Dig a hole in the center. Okay, so I'm gonna show you. You're not able to see, but you dig a hole in the center. Okay. Okay. Hi everyone. Okay, so if you have any comments, you can type in the chat. Or any questions and we can help you. So after you dig already, you leave it aside, and now we're going to split the plants up. Okay, so these plants that we are going to use today is called the Vittonia plant. Okay, this is the Vittonia plant. So Vittonia plant you can get from the nursery, or I did see before in Giant. You can actually get from Giant also. Okay, so it's very nice colors. It's green, there is pink veins and green plants, and we also have the pink plants. Okay, so they come in different colors. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we are going to separate our plants. Okay, so we can even separate them and mix them together so I can have green and the pink together. Okay, so let me, I'm gonna show you how I separate the plants. Okay, be gentle. Okay, squeeze out. Okay, you can put the pots aside. So we're going to split. Okay, use your hands and split. Be careful not to squash the roots. Okay, we just separate it gently. Okay, so it depending on the size of the plastic bottles. Okay, so if the plastic bottle is big, you can put more plants, but if the plastic bottle is small, then you have to estimate your plant size. Okay, so I can choose another plant. Put this. Okay, so I can choose. I'll just put this over here first. Later I'll teach you how to put it in. Maybe I'll choose this Vittonia plant. That's very nice, the color. So now I'm going to take it out. You can squeeze the pot gently and you take it out and you separate it. Okay. Careful of the roots. Okay, you can take a little bit of soy and then, so like what I have just said, depending on the size of the plastic bottles. Okay, so if your plastic bottle is big, you can use more plants, but if your plastic bottle is smaller, you use lesser plants. Okay, so now we are going to put our Vittonia plants inside the plastic bottle after we decorated. So I'm going to put this over here. First, we have to dig a hole. Okay, using your finger. Okay, so there's a hole inside. Then, you Then after that, you food. Okay, so you still keep the soil, but just a little bit, you rub it off the soil. Okay, can you see the roots? The roots. Yes, just be gentle with the roots. After you dig a hole, we place it in to the soil. Why we have to place it into the soil? So that they will get the nutrients. Okay, push it in. Okay, push it in. So you push, when you push it in, don't see the roots. Okay, cover the roots. Cover the soil. Cover the roots with the soil. Okay, so it will look something like this. But it's still shaky. So what you have to do is to push it in. And you have to flatten the soil. And you can actually put more soil, okay? So for this, is like maybe it's a bit squeezy, so I will just put one plant, okay? But you can actually mix the colors, but for me, because my pot is too small, my bottle, so I just use one plant. Okay, and I squeeze it in, put it inside the soil, and cover it up. Okay? So, in order to cover up, I can use the soil. Okay, I will use the soil. Okay, can you just put at the side? Can you just put at the side? So we can use our hands, you know, to flatten it, so the plant will be stable and it won't move too much. Okay. So use your hands to flatten it, but be careful, don't flatten your plant, okay? Just flatten the soil. Okay, make sure that it's not easily pulled out. Okay, so we flatten. Flatten this. Okay, so you can give a little tap on your plant to see if it's stable. Yes, so this is stable. So after you are done flattening, okay. So the next step is we are going to decorate. Yes, the terrarium, we can actually make it very nice. Can you see the plant? This is the plant inside. So what we can do is actually to decorate with color stones. Okay, so all these are color stones. Okay, the color stones, what we can do is you can get from Daiso. Okay, so they have different colors, nice colors. You can decorate it. So I can decorate. I like blue, so I'll put blue. Okay, when you put the stones in, remember, do not cover the plant, so the plant is like the main character. So we just decorate it with the stones just to cover the soil. See, I'll put the stones in. Okay, for me, I'll use blue, but if you want to mix, it's okay too. You can mix the colors. You can just spread, not too much. Okay, so it will look something like this. Okay, so can you see the spots? You just go around. Okay, so after you do it, you try not to shake, or else the stones and the soil will mix up. So you have to hold it carefully. Okay, so after you are done, okay, after done decorating, what you can do is you can decorate with different ornaments or different decorative items. Like if you have the rainbow at home, you can put the rainbow inside, or you can put any cut like if you want to give like a gift, like a Merry Christmas, you can put a Santa Claus, or you can have any small figurines at home, you can put the figurines too. So I have some figurines here, and what you can do is you can actually use a very nice toothpick. It's like those for kids. You can use toothpick. You can get it from Daiso. Okay, so you can use very nice. There's the monkey or the cat, and you can actually just poke it in. Yes, can you see the monkey is inside? And mama, you can just decorate it this way. You put the shape, see the cat, the monkeys inside, and then also have the very nice koala bear. Okay, so I'm gonna put the koala bear inside too. So it looks like the animal terrarium. So I have the monkey. I have it fixed the koala. Just push it in. I have the koala, and I have the cat. Yes, and it will look very nice. So you can put it at home and decorate it. So after we are done, and now what we're going to do, the last step, is to water our plant. Okay, so we're going to water our plant. Okay, so when watering our plant, we use the bottle cap as a gauge. Okay, we use the bottle cap as a gauge. So I use one water cap. Okay, when you water the plant, you do not water directly on the plant. You water around the soil, okay? So I'm going to give one water cap. Okay, you water on the soil, and we estimate about 2 water cap. Okay, 2 water cap of water. Go around the soil. Okay, and then you are done. So you are done with your terrarium. Okay, you just adjust a little bit. Yep. So you are done with the terrarium. Very nice terrarium you have. So we use the plastic bottles by cutting them up. And then we file it with the sandpaper to make it smooth the edges over here. Then we decorate it by painting and pasting the pom-poms. And then the first step for the terrarium is to put the stones first. The stones as the base. Then we do the soil. Remember, we put the soil. Yes, and we can use the garden soil. And then we also, after that, we dig a hole. And you can use different plants like the Petunia. Okay, today we use Petunia. Or if you have succulent, you can find succulent. You can use a succulent too. Okay, and after that we dig a hole and put it in. And we stabilize the plant. After that we put color stones, different stones, small color stones to decorate it. And then we also use different small figurines. The ones that I recommend is you can get from Daiso, or you can get from any other shop that you can find that have small figurines like this, the mushroom and the cat. Okay, so and now I'm going to teach you how to take care of your plant. So just now I teach you, right, that you have to water the plants with about 2 water caps. Okay, and go around the soil, not the plant, go around the soil so it can absorb the water. So now how are we going to take care? You don't water it every day. 1 week, you can water it twice or thrice. Because it's an open terrarium, you have to water it 1 week about twice or thrice. But if it's a closed, if you want to use a closed terrarium, some of you, if you have this kind of container at home, what you can do is the same step. You put the stones first, then the soil, then after that, the plant. So after you put the plant already, then you put the stones. It's the same step that what I show you. It's just that it's a closed terrarium. So if you have like a container like this, you can do a closed terrarium Well, for crostarium, you have to water it about 3 water caps, and then you close it and do not open it anymore because it's a crostarium. So it's like a ecosystem. So it inside it will water itself. So you don't have to water the plants anymore unless you see if it look a little bit dry. Then you open up. Hi. Then you open up. Then after that, you open up and then you water it. But remember, when you see any water condensed, if you see any water condensed on the crostarium, it's okay. Don't wipe it because it's actually helping the plant inside the crostarium to grow. So for crostarium, you don't have to water it, just leave it. But we did the open terrarium today, so you have to water it 1 week about twice or thrice, and then keep it away from direct sunlight, okay? So, and then you can care for your plants, and it's very easy. You just use the simple plastic bottles just to do it. So, if you have any plastic bottles at home, don't throw it away. We can make it into a beautiful art piece. And next week, we are also going to show you how to do a National Day hat using plastic plate. Okay, so do join us at next week, the same Facebook page, Hansak Galleria, and we are going to show you how to do a National Day hat. Okay, so I see you next week. Thank you for joining us today. Bye.